Today, I've got a great movie. This movie came out earlier in the year, and it is being remembered very much here now as the season moves on. It's called The Way Back, and its star is Ben Affleck, and he's never been better. Welcome, Ben.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Welcome to Contenders. And this movie is a drama about a guy who was a big high school basketball star. His life then went in a different direction, and he turned to the bottle, as they say. Tragedy hit his family. Now he's coming back as the coach of the high school team that he went to high school at, the basketball team. Jack Cunningham is the character's name, and this is a real good character drama for you, Ben. And I want to show people a little bit of it now. So let's take a look at The Way Back.
You know, my dad told me last night. He said that you got a full ride to Kansas, and that you just quit. No reason. Why?
My father didn't like me very much. And someone told him I was good at basketball. And he paid a lot more attention to me. And the better I got, the more love he showed me. And I realized it wasn't me that he loved. It was what I could do. I made a lot of bad decisions, Brandon. I had a lot of regret. Went away from basketball, got into a different life, got into drugs. Spent a lot of time hurting myself, trying to hurt my father. It was my wife who got me out of that. I never picked up basketball again.
All right, I gotta ask you, taking on this role, you've done a lot of these bigger movies, bigger roles here. This is real character driven and a kind of smaller drama, the kind of thing studios used to do decades ago, but don't do as much anymore.
Yeah, it was interesting. It was it's kind of my taste. I mean, it's I've always had a poster of The Verdict, up in my house, and I came of age during, sort of becoming aware of the great age of American cinema in the 70s. When I became a teenager in the 80s, those were the movies that we kind of looked up to. Most of them were character dramas, and with, great performances and great directors and so on. And studios were making a lot of movies like that. They don't make very many anymore. This was an opportunity to do one. When I got to direct my first movie, I did Gone Baby Gone. The first movie I wrote was Good One Thing. This is sort of what I feel most passionate about and interested in, both as a filmmaker, writer, and as an actor. And I'd also, I just love Brad's script so much, and it gave me a chance to explore a really broad range of emotions and experiences. As you say, the character's gone through tragedy, and it's a movie about recovering from the things that are really difficult in our lives, the bad, immutable things that sometimes happen, and how you deal with them. And I think Gavin O'Connor, the director, handles it in a really mature, non-saccharine, non-artificial way. The character loses his son and causes his life to go into a spiral, and it's about how he gets out of it and kind of re-engages in life, which is the theme of that I've always been drawn to.
Yeah, me too. I love this kind of story, and watching a character kind of coming up from the bootstraps here. It reminded me, I had just watched just a few weeks ago The Verdict with Paul Newman, and the kinds of things Paul Newman was driven to, and actors like that, character drama like this. And this sort of reminded me of that.
The Verdict's been a huge influence on my life. Sidney Lumet is a brilliant director. Obviously, Paul Newman made amazing choices as an actor. Hud, Cool Hand Luke, Cat Hots, and I mean, Butch and Sundance, The Sting, Paul Newman, Color of Money, The Hustler. He was one of the great, 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 greats. So yeah, he's definitely been somebody I've always looked up to and admired. And And also that, you know, with the movie, like The Verdict, as you mentioned, you know, it sort of flies in the face of a certain kind of conventional wisdom that's sometimes trafficked in by studios, where you're not allowed to have your protagonist be flawed.
Right.
And if you don't do that, I think you make it's very hard to make the character relatable. If they're too flawed, you know, if they're a bad person, obviously they keep the audience at a distance. But I think the most resonant, what generates the most empathy, is to have somebody who struggles, who has a difficult time, as we all frankly do. We like to sort of hide it, keep it inside, pretend we're all fine. But, you know, most of us have things that we're dealing with that are upsetting and difficult. And so the question of how you reconcile that and what you do is really interesting to me and interesting to explore in movies. And I loved doing it.
Yeah, I love seeing it too. And we see as this film goes on, no easy answers for him. He does have a relapse. You go into that harrowing scene where you're driving and you know, as an audience member, you're just screaming at the screen, please don't do this. But, but the movie doesn't cop out in any way. This is the second film you've done with the director, Gavin O'Connor. You did The Accountant with him before. What's that relationship like in making this?
Well, with Gavin, you know, one of the things we have similar taste, and taste to me is the most important thing in a director. I think that's their principal job. And he was more interested in the character in The Accountant and to what extent he was on the spectrum and the interesting sort of unusual choices character-wise that we were making than he was in the shooting and killing and fighting and stuff. And I was drawn to that. I loved the way he handled sports, you know, in an authentic way in movies like Miracle and Warrior. And we just became friends, and he was somebody I trusted with a piece of material that, like, you know, inherently you have to take some risks with. You have to kind of lay yourself out there for the audience. And a director that, you know, you don't share the same sensibility with could really make you look bad. So this was somebody that I really trusted with a movie that was very important to me. And then I also knew, as a recovering alcoholic myself, and people would make conclusions about the similarities between my life and the movie. So I didn't want the movie to be false in some ways. And also, there are also people, a lot of people who deal with, I mean, millions and millions and millions of people who deal with addictive behavior, compulsive behavior. And, you know, you have a certain responsibility. I don't want to make an issue movie or a movie of the week, but you have to do it authentically, because there are people for whom these are really important issues in their lives.
As an actor, how much of your own life do you bring into a role, particularly this role? How much do you do that to really get into the character here of Jack Cunningham?
Well, you're never going to have experienced everything that every character you're going to play has experienced. So to a certain extent, obviously, part of the job is using your imagination, your emotional imagination. And part of your job is trying to find parallels and similarities between your own life experience and the experience that the character's going through. And even if they're not exact, you know, sort of combining them and associating them in your mind. And also, you know, you have to do research. So it's a lot of different things, but really most broadly, you know, for me, I find I'm more comfortable and I think better as an actor and like acting more, the more life experience I've had, the more ups, the more downs, the more, you know, having children, being divorced, recovering from alcoholism, all kinds of things that have pushed me to look deeper into myself and experience a broader range of my own emotions, makes me more facile with that and allows me to bring that to my work. And so, you know, paradoxically, I really loved making this movie, even though there was a lot of sadness and tragedy in it. And also there is hope.
Yeah. And what a great cast that you have, especially the team, the kids that you're working with here. Have you ever played basketball before in school or anything?
Not in an organized way. Not a basketball player. I did watch a lot of tape of a lot of coaches and work with basketball coaches. And fortunately, I didn't have to be on the team because we would have been in trouble. But those guys were amazing. They inspired me. To connect with them and to be able to try to gain their respect was kind of what I used to parallel getting their respect as a coach in the movie. And what it brought me was a relationship with these young men that was just really special and extraordinary and reminded me of the importance of mentorship at that age. I had a great drama teacher who really inspired me in high school. And I remember Terrence Malick once said to me, you know, like, man, always you know, stay connected with young people because we get ossified and we, you know, and there's really something to that, you know. It reminded me of, I did a movie called School Ties 30 years ago, and it reminded me of being in that movie and just the pure joy of being on the set, of acting, you know, of getting to say a line, of why I got into this in the first place. It was a really rewarding aspect of the movie, the relationship with those young men.
I think it really shows through on this film. I've seen it a couple of times now. It holds up the second time even better than the first, and your performance is terrific, Ben. So congratulations on it, and thanks for joining us today on Contenders.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
Absolutely.